Assalamualaikum and very good morning. Okay, so my name is Bob Iskandar. I'm a lecturer in pharmaceutics in Faculty of Health Science, my course. So today I'm going to share with you a prescription or a practical, which is a student will be given a task to prepare a product called mixture magnesium trisilicates. So this is just a real situation in a hospital. So if a pharmacist in outpatient pharmacy, so usually the daily task would be receive a prescription from the doctor. So today, as a practical in liquid dosage form, I'm going to share with you a practical number one, which is mixture magnesium trisilicate. What is mixture magnesium trisilicate? Mixture magnesium trisilicate is an antacid used in a patient who have gastric. Gastric is a condition whereby a patient have hyperacidity or too much acid secretions in their body, or in this case, in their stomach. Okay, so mixture magnesium trisilicate is a mixture we use to neutralize the acid being secreted too much in their body. So today, a prescription called mixture magnesium trisilicate BPC, I'm going to share with you on the screening process, the preparations, how to prepare the label, as well as at the end of the day, I'm going to share with you the products that we have produced by today's practical sessions. Okay, when we receive a prescription, first and foremost, we need to do a process called screening process. So screening process is a process whereby a pharmacist need to check with the reference. In this case, we will use a British Pharmaceutical Codex 1973. This is the official books which is used in a lot of medical institutions. So for today, for mixture magnesium trisilicate BPC, we will check the formula, the indication, as well as the usage and the dose inside a BPC 1973. Okay, so this is the British Pharmaceutical Codex. First and foremost, we need to check at the index. Look at the magnesium mixture trisilicate BPC. So here, look at the index, and then we find in page 747. Okay, so this is the formula according to the BPC 1973. So when we prepare this prescription, this product is based on the BPC 1973. This is the official formula, and then we will make a prescription, a product according to the order by the physician. So if you look at here, the prescription show that the doctor requests for 200 ml. Bear in mind that official formula in BPC, every product is up to 1000 ml. So we need to amend the dose as well as the volume of the product according to the doctor's prescription. Okay, so I'm going to share with you on the process of how we want to do a product based on the prescription requested by the physicians. Okay, so as you can see here from the BPC, the formulation, the official formulation, every product is in a form of 1000 ml. So if you look at the prescriptions, the product, the doctor requested for 200 ml. So how do we need to change and amend the ingredients as well as the quantity of the product according to the request by the doctor? So this is involves some a bit calculations, but a very simple calculations. It's a ratio calculation. So I'm going to share with you on how the calculations takes place. So this is the product, the ingredients, okay? And then we have master formula. What is master formula? Actually, master formula is the ingredients as well as the quantity directly taken from the BPC. And then we have our prescriptions quantity that we want. Okay, so number one, we have a magnesium trisilicate. Number two, we have light magnesium carbonate. And then we have sodium bicarb. And then we have a peppermint. And then lastly, we have a chloroform water. And lastly, water up to 1000 ml. Okay, so for magnesium trisilicate in a brief PC, it requires 50 gram. Light magnesium carbonate as well as 50 gram. Sodium bicarb also 50 gram. Peppermint is a 25 ml. And chloroform water 500 ml. And then lastly, we top up the water until the required amount. It is 1 liter lah in BPC. But according to the prescription, doctor requested for 200 ml. So this is the process on how we want to do a calculations, okay? So according to the prescription here, the doctor requested for 200 ml. So how we want to convert or to amend the quantity of the ingredients according to the BPC 1973. So this one, we need to do a simple calculation. So in 1000 ml, we need 50 gram. But for the required prescription, we want to prepare a product of 200 ml volume. So 200 ml divided by 1000 ml times 50 gram. This one also the same, 200 divided by 1000 ml times 50 gram. 200 divided by 1000 ml times 50. 200 divided by 1000 ml times 25 ml. And then this one also the same, 200 divided by 1000 times 500 ml. Okay, so here, okay, after we do some calculations, so this one we will get 10 gram here as well, 10 gram here as well, 10 gram for peppermint, 5 ml for chloroform water is a 100 ml, and lastly, we top up with water until the required amount is 200 ml. So this is how we do a simple calculations according to the requested by the doctor. So if you look at inside a BPC, the formula is everything with a volume of 1000 ml. Okay. So I'm going to discuss with you the function for each of the ingredients in a mixture magnesium trisilicate. Okay, first we have a mixed magnesium trisilicate as well as light magnesium carbonate. So magnesium trisilicate and magnesium carbonate is an antacid. In this case, in mixture magnesium trisilicate, this is the active ingredient. So the active ingredient in mixture magnesium trisilicate is mixture magnesium carbonate and magnesium trisilicate. Then we have sodium bicarb. What is the function of sodium bicarb in this preparation? Sodium bicarb in this preparation act as a salt or stability agent. And then we have a peppermint. What is the function of peppermint? Peppermints usually we use to give flavor effect, or at the end of the product, when we taste the product, it gives us like a gas sensational, like a peppermint taste and so on. So it's just like for flavoring agent. And then we have a chloroform water. Chloroform water in this case act as a preservative. And then water is a diluent. Okay, so in this case we have 10 gram of magnesium trisilicate, 10 gram of light magnesium carbonate, 10 gram of sodium bicarb, 5 ml of peppermint, 100 ml of chloroform water, and we top up the water until the required amount of 200 ml. Okay, so here is the materials as well as the ingredients that we need to prepare a mixture magnesium trisilicate BPC 73. first of all, we need to assemble the things. Okay, so we have here is a measuring cylinder cone, and then we need a glass rod here. Okay, here is a spatula, it's a stainless steel spatula, and then we have a porcelain mortar and pestles. Okay, make sure already clean up. Okay, thoroughly clean, and then we have a weighing board here. Then we have an analytical balance, okay, to weigh each of the ingredients. So this is the ingredients that we use to prepare mixture magnesium trisilicate. This is the sodium bicarbonate. It's a powder. Here is a powder of magnesium trisilicate. This is a chloroform water, single strength. This is a light magnesium carbonate powder. And lastly, don't forget your bottle to fill up your product at the end of the practical session. So for today's case, I'm going to use a clear bottle because mixture magnesium trisilicate is an internal preparations. Okay, so this is the process of weighing each of the ingredients. So we have a weighing board here. First of all, you need to put the weighing board on top of the analytical balance, and then you need to press a tab. Okay, so once the value here indicate as 0.001, we can start the process. Okay, so according to the prescription, we will start the process of weighing now. Then we need to calibrate the bottle that we are going to use at the end of our practical session to 200 ml. So this is a clear glass bottle. Okay, so we need to calibrate the bottle by using measuring cylinder. Okay, and then we need to put a sticker at the meniscus at the top of the 200 ml, so that after this, when we put our product, we can top up with water until the indicated line of the sticker. Okay, so here is the preparation and ingredients of mixture magnesium trisilicate. So this is 10 gram of sodium bicarbonate, this is a 10 gram of magnesium trisilicate, and this is a 10 gram of light magnesium carbonate. Okay, first of all, we need to put magnesium sodium bicarbonate in the mortar. Okay, so mix and triturate it lightly just to reduce the particles of the powder, so that make it easier the things to mix. Okay, when we put in the water later, mix it very lightly. Okay. Then we put a 10 gram of magnesium trisilicate. Okay, again, triturate and mix it very lightly. Okay, then we put light magnesium carbonate 10 gram as well. Okay, mix it lightly and triturate it. So the purpose of the trituration is to ensure that each of the powder can be mixed thoroughly and homogeneously. Okay. Then we can put some water around 10 to 20 ml just to make a small paste. Ensure that the mixing process, the mixing direction is a unidirection. Do not mix in opposite direction. So once you triturate according to the clockwise, so ensure that until the end of the trituration process, ensure in a clockwise process. One direction only. Okay, can add up some water to dilute it. Okay, done. So this is how it looks like, the initial paste of mixture magnesium trisilicate. And then we will transfer it in a bottle. So we need a funnel here to transfer the initial paste of mixture magnesium trisilicate Okay. And then we can put 100 ml of chloroform water. Okay. And then we can add up the peppermint, 5 ml. And then lastly, we top up with distilled water until the indicated marks. And then close the closure of the bottle, then shake it. Okay. So this is the mixture magnesium trisilicate. So after this, we will going to do a labeling process. Okay. So this is the labeling process. Okay. So basically, we have two type of labeling. So this is the red color label, and this one is a black color label. So what is the difference? Black color label we use for internal preparation. For in this case, mixture magnesium trisilicate is an internal mixture, so we will use the black color label. For red color label, we use only for external preparations. Okay, so I'm going to show to you the process of doing labeling. Okay, so first of all, you need to look at the end of the product volume is 200 ml. It's a magnesium trisilicate mixture. Okay, so this is the label that we have written. So it's a 200 ml magnesium trisilicate mixture BPC. So the indications requested by the doctor to the patient is take 15 ml 3 times a day. So the patient name is Nabila. So expiry date is going to be around 2 weeks after we prepare this mixture. So keep out reach of children and the name of the institution. So in this case, we use Faculty Health Science of my course. So we paste at the mixture bottle, then shake the bottle. So finish. Okay, so this is our final product of mixture magnesium trisilicate BPC 73. So I hope you can get some beneficial information from my sharing. So at the end of the practical session today, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's my course officials. And don't forget to click like buttons and have a nice day. We're going to meet again soon. Okay, bye-bye.